Hey y'all, so I just finished up my bench workout and came home and decided that I was going to do abs here so I could show you guys the quick 6-minute ab routine that I do after every workout, or that I try to do or should do after every workout. So yeah, I'll walk you through it as I go, but it's pretty straightforward, pretty easy stuff. You're gonna wanna have a stopwatch or a timer or be able to look at a clock while you do this, because everything I do by time. So you start with 1 minute of just really straightforward crunches. So I always try and keep my knees at a 90 degree angle, like my calves are resting on a tabletop. And I try on really thinking about the contraction of my top two abdominal muscles in order to bring everything up. So the next minute, you can either do hip lifts, hip rollovers, or you can drop your legs 6 inches above the ground and slowly roll them up over and back down. If you choose to do the full rollover, it will stretch your lower back, your hamstrings, the sides of your butt, and depending on how tight you are, it might stretch down the sides of your legs. Something to be aware of when you decide what variation to choose. With these, I focus on the quality of the movement rather than how many of them I can do. I really am trying not to use any momentum in the rollover. So next minute, crunch up and touch your toes, and back down. For a lot of people, if you have tight hamstrings, these are gonna be challenging at first. You can bend your knees and just think about crunching up as you work on your hamstring mobility, and you can fully extend your legs. Fully extend them and just crunch up and tap your toes. With this, I try and think about getting that same good upper ab crunch I got in the first minute of exercise. I try not to really move from my shoulders and my head too much. I don't want to pull on that cervical spine at all. I really want all the motion to come from contracting my abdominals. All right, so now we do 30 seconds of flutter kicks at 6 inches over the ground. I like to put my hands under my butt. It protects my low back. And I feel like it just puts me at a little bit of a better angle to really focus on that abdominal contraction. 5 seconds left, and then the second half of this minute, so another 30 seconds, you're gonna switch, just kick the camera, from doing a vertical flutter to doing a horizontal flutter or a scissor kick. Still at 6 inches, still got my hands under my tush. I point my toes a little bit when I do these, not a super hard point so that my calves are contracted, but just a little gentle point. Make my legs nice and long. All right. For this minute, we're gonna do crunches set to side. So for these, You'll notice I don't move my legs. What I'm focusing on when I do these crunches is, can I lift the opposite shoulder blade off of the ground and leave my hips planted while I'm crunching side to side? So the side that I'm crunching towards, that upper arm is going to be flat to the ground. And I'm trying to get as much rotation as possible from hip to shoulder across my body. So I'm trying to think about moving my body on a diagonal. Again, my chin is tucked the whole time, and my hands are back there just to support the weight a little bit, so I'm not pulling on my cervical spine. Last minute, you're gonna go back to that 6 inches, and you're gonna do 30 seconds of circles to the right, or clockwise circles. By this point, you should feel a burn in your abs, just a little bit. It gets easier the more times you do it, but this will really help to build up the stability in your core and its endurance. All right, 30 seconds. All you do is switch your circles to the left or counterclockwise. If the circles are hard for you, rather than having two legs together, you can cross at the ankles or you can cross at the knee like this. And that'll help take a little bit and make it a little bit easier. And that's it. Really nice, quick 6 minute ab routine that's gonna start to build up the endurance in your core. So I focus a lot more on the endurance capabilities of my core because I wanna make sure that if I'm squatting, my core has to be engaged from the time I unrack the bar until the time I re-rack it. Now I want to make sure if I'm doing sets of 10 at 70% that my core is strong enough to keep my body upright and to keep everything protected for the 2 minutes that I'm probably going to have 200 pounds on my back. This is not going to be really an ab routine that's going to get you like the six-pack shred for summer. But it's an ab routine that's going to help to keep your core safe throughout all of your lifting. And a strong core also helps translate to better balance, so it's going to help you keep you safe in your daily life too. So, quick, easy 6 minutes. Give this video a comment or a like, and let me know what other videos like this you want to see. Have a great day!